Hello, you are welcome to my channel. If you are new, my name is Nelly Carl and you are most welcome. Consider subscribing in this channel in the subscription button below and make sure that you give this video a thumbs up as well. If you are a returning subscriber, you are welcome back. Make sure that you give this video a thumbs up as well. Thank you so much. So in today's video, I'm gonna be telling you different ways you can handle toxic friends, negative friends. When I made a video of how you can know the negative friends or the different types of negative friends that we always be around with, many people were requesting that I do a video of how you can deal with such negative friends. Like now, they have known the different types of the negative friends that they have, how they deal with them. So today I'm gonna be showing you the different way that you can deal with the negative friends. So without a further ado, let's get started. One way that you can handle or deal with a negative friend is by sitting them down. Have a conversation together with them in an open place, openly, like point blank. Tell them what they are bad at doing, tell them their faults, and if they're willing to change, it is okay. If they're not willing to change, then you have to change. It may take a while for your heart to heal after maybe leaving them. But let me tell you, that is the best way that you can deal with the negative friends. Just change. If they can't change, then change your own ways. As time goes on, you will find that your heart heals and you will be free. Another thing is by ignoring them. Just a mere ignoring, maybe for example, their calls, their meetings, conversations, like maybe you've been invited by them for an out, you can ignore them. Tell them you're busy or you're having somewhere that you're going, you are having some visitors that you're expecting, and that is how you ignore them. But if you give them most of your time, they'll use their time to hurt you the more. So you better ignore them. They call you, make it a missed call. When they call you for a meeting, tell them you are doing something different at that time and you may not be able to attend their meetings or their conversation. That is the way you can secure your heart. And let me tell you, at the end of it all, you'll be having peace in your mind, in your heart, and you'll be so much okay. Another way you can ignore them is by ignoring their insults. I'm telling you, these negative friends can come with a lot of insults. Every time they might be wanting to insult you, but let me tell you the truth. If you start ignoring the insults, that is one way that your heart will heal. You will be so much free. Like when they insult you, just take it like it has not hurt you. Like sometimes maybe they may call you different names just to make sure that you're upset. But if you show them that you're insulted, they'll go on insulting you the more. Show them as though something has not really happened to you, like you are not nagged about what they say. You will conquer them just in a simple way like that. Ignore the insults, ignore the conversations, ignore everything about them. Slowly by slowly, they'll start leaving you. And that is how you will deal with them. Another way is getting rid of them. Even if you're relying on them for certain benefits, maybe like they're supporting you in another way or the other, that is not the case. That is not a reason you should stick around with them. But when you stick around, just because you're benefiting from them for certain things, no, you continue hurting yourself. But if you let go, talk to your heart and just move along, walk your own path, and you will be so much fun. Get rid of them and move your own lane. I'm telling you, by the end of it all, you'll be so much free, you'll be so much happy, and you'll live a comfortable life. Another one is never share secrets with people you don't trust. If you realize someone is a negative friend, maybe like they do certain things that really disappoint you, they are backbiters, they have those bad characters, why do you go on telling them your secrets? Just know that these negative friends always don't want the best for you. So if you go on telling them your secrets, maybe like a success you're trying to achieve or a business plan that you're trying to chase on, they'll do something wrong. They'll just go behind you to make sure that that plan is done. And I'm telling you, you'll regret in your life. So look for people you trust with your secrets in your life. Will be really an amazing life. So check on the people that you share your secrets with. Check on the people that you pour your heart out to, and you'll never regret in life. Another thing is always have self-positive talk. Don't have negative talks in your life. Don't ever have negative talks about your life. Be this person who always have the positive talks. I am favored, I am a conqueror, I'm beautiful, I'm this, positive talk. But most negative friends always have the negative words that they put in our hearts. So if you continue with that mentality that maybe this is what they said and okay, I am like that. No, that is not how you will heal your heart. Your heart will only be healed if you speak positive to your life, and that is how you conquer them. Another thing is also setting boundaries. Set a boundary and enforce it. Don't just set it and leave it like that. No, set it and follow it. Let your no be your no, and let your yes be yes. Let them know that when you say yes, it is a yes, and let them know that when you say a no, it really means no. Don't just say yes and back in your mind you are meaning something else. Stick to your boundaries and they'll respect that. Another thing is forgiveness. Try so much that you forgive the negative friends that you have. No matter what they have done to you, no matter what thing they have done unto your life, just go on forgiving them. Release your heart and just know forgiveness opens great doors. The more that you hold them into your heart, that is the more that you hurt yourself much. So release them, let it be. Life is all about moving on. Move on to the next stage. You never know, you will get opportunities. When you release them out of your heart, you will be free and you will live a peaceful life. So I say forgiveness is the best way that you will deal with these negative friends. Another thing is by sending them love. You can conquer all these negative friends by just showing them love. Send them the love messages, send them the love gifts, and they'll feel so much happy. Like, even if they have insulted you or even if they have done negative things into your life, when you send them love back, they'll realize that you are a different person. You are not hurt with what they do, and at times they will tend to come back to their normal senses and they will repent about what they did wrong, and they will turn to be different people. And with the time, if they are good people, they will tend to be the best friends ever. So by sending them love, that is another way that you'll be dealing with the negativity that they have. Another thing is by spending time with the positive friends. Most of the times you have to conquer these negative friends by limiting your time with them. Spend more time with the people that make you really happy. Go to those conversations that really make you strengthen, that makes you move on, than being in conversations that really nag you, like the conversations of the negative people. Spend more time with the people that make you happy. If a certain conversation makes you happy, then you have to spend more time with that. That is what heals your heart, and limit yourself from the negative conversations. That is how you deal with the friends. But if you tend to give them more time, they will use that time to hurt you. Spend more time with the positive people, the people that make you happy. Another thing is knowing your worth. Know what you're worth of and know what you're not worth of. Know what is good for you and know what is not good for you. But if you don't really value your worth, you will not know what exactly is worth of you. Like, after knowing your worth, you are able to know that this friend is valuable for me and the other friend is not worth for me. So when you deal with that thing, knowing your worth, you know exactly which friend to keep around and which friend not to keep around. So valuing and knowing your worth is the best way that you can deal with the negative friends. Another thing is trying to ignore conflicts and emotions that may bring fights and other things. For example, if a negative friend nags you and sometimes you feel like you're too emotional and you want to fight back, I'm telling you, just control the emotions. Sometimes emotions may drive us so much quickly that we may find ourselves into problems. Sometimes the negative friends may nag us a lot, like do some things for very long, that sometimes we are emotionally moved and feel like we want to fight back. But if you ignore such, you will find that your life is so much relieved. For example, someone can just backbite you on wrong things that you're not even aware of, or things that are not even true about your life. But if you are this person who ignores a lot, you'll save your heart from hurting. You can do this by distancing yourself from such conflicts, or if you've known that your emotions may overtake you, try to distance yourself from such things. Be like you've not heard about it, and that is how you save your life. Another way of how you can deal with the negative friends is by being so much intelligent and being so much focused. Know that this thing is wrong. Have that mind that tells you, that interprets for you, that maybe such a conversation will lead you into a problem, and try to internalize with it. Know that this thing is bad and know how to handle it. If you have that intelligence, if you are focused in that way, you will deal with it. And sometimes you have to know that this thing has come in the wrong direction and look for ways of how you can handle it. Don't just wait for it to happen and you fall into a pit. Have that intelligence that really tells you it is bad, yes, and how would you handle it. If you know only that, that would be your game changer. So guys, that is all I had for you today about how you can deal with the negative friends. And I hope this video has been helpful for you. If you know some of the ways that you can deal with the negative friends, please comment down in the comment section below and let's share all this together. You never know whom you're saving. Please, if you've not yet subscribed to my channel, go ahead and subscribe and make sure that you give this video a thumbs up as well. Thank you. Bye bye.